Give me two selections. It's raining out here, and I don't want nobody to get sick. Amen. Come on, praise Him.
I'm chasing after you. No matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more. I'm chasing after you. No matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more. Say more and more.
More and more.
Say more and more.
Table, hamburger table, hot dog table. If you desire to get something to eat, you're welcome to go get something to eat. Everything is free, drinks and everything, but we're getting ready to get it kicked off out here get it going out here for what we're going to do. So in other words, if you want something to eat, don't be ashamed to go get it. Tell them what you want on it, because when the rain comes, I'm snatching. If we got to stop, I'm snatching everything I'm going in the building. Won't be tired of getting no hamburger then. Amen. I'm just being a real pastor. Too many fake folk for me around here. Amen. We thank God I'm being real about it. Amen. When it's time to go, we got to go. Amen. So if you desire something, your kids want something, you're more than welcome to get it. But we thank God again. I want to make that clear. All that is free. Let the children eat. Let them enjoy. But we're going to turn this over until our pastor, Tyshawn Wilson, he's going to come on today. He's the reason why we're here. He's the head of this church in the street. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to turn over his hands.
Amen. Come on, let's give God some glory. Come on, let's give God some praise. The songster said, oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. We come to bring y'all church in the streets, you know, by way of New Life Deliverance. Pastor Katrina Rosenborough, Apostle Henry Rosenborough, we came to celebrate with them on today. What we're doing is we're teaching on careers. This is against drugs, gangs, and violence. I also want y'all to acknowledge my wife on today, Evangelist Dana Wilson, on today. What we're going to do is we'll have a skit in about 15 minutes. I want y'all to focus in on this burgundy Honda Accord in about 15 minutes. When I say skit, you focus your attention on that car, all right? And then, not only that, we're going to have another skit in about 15 minutes prior to that in that black Maserati over there, right? So I want y'all to pay attention to everything that's going on, because it's going to lead to a funeral scene in the end, all right? Okay, come on, let's give God praise. We get ready to start with the popcorn at the bouncy houses. We're going to be teaching on careers for the kids. Not only that, we're going to be teaching on relationships, family, unity, health, and strength, okay? Amen. All right, let's get it. Can you play some more music? And I'll let y'all know when we're doing the skit, okay? And I want y'all to really focus in and zero in on these skits, because they have a lot of meaning. It's stuff that goes on in your community. It's stuff that we're dealing with in every neighborhood in America. So please pay attention to what's going on, because some of these things can be going on in your family and in your home. Amen? Amen.
Oh God,
how great.
Destruction, deception, and drugs overtaking our community. We have situations going on with this marijuana epidemic. And what's going on is our children are going crazy. Our children are spending everything they got. They're dealing with issues, problems, situations. This marijuana is making our community very stressful, very frustrating. You know, people are struggling. People are dealing with issues, problems, and situations. I want y'all to take a look at by this burgundy car. These are some of the things that are going on in our community. This is some of the stuff that we're dealing with. Ted, we ready for you. Come on, y'all. Let's give God some glory for what's taking place.
Man, it's been a stressful week. Good grief. Gotta have me something to relax me. Oh, shoot. There go my boy.
Billy!
Yeah, boy, what's going on? Hey, man, what's going on with you? Chilling, man. Chilling, man. Good, man. Man, you both.
Yeah, man, let me get some. Sure, I know. I gotta have something. Let me get some.
What's going on with you?
You alright?
Good.
Appreciate it. Hey, stay close now, because, Dream, I been. Yeah, that's up, boy. Go over here and chill out. Whew. Get my mess together. Hey, wait, he said, is it real? So. Can't wait to get in this.
There we go.
Yeah. Yeah, that's tough. That's what I need right there. Okay, it would look like it might snow. Damn. Good as this man been pretty all day, boy. Like, we gonna get some snow right here, boy. All right. And tell you what, boy. I hope it don't snow too hard around here. Woo, boy, that's some good stuff here, boy. Hot, though.
See, a lot of people in our community don't know that weed laced with PCP. Our marijuana is laced with fentanyl and all types of drugs. We're going through a lot of things, and there's a lot of people in our community that are being ran crazy by this drug epidemic.
Just watch what's going on. This is what could happen to you. You could actually die from it. You could actually go crazy with it. You can actually lose your life from it. So you have to make a decision today. You have to begin to think about what you're doing and the choices you make. If you know people around you are getting high, you know you got family members that are doing things that are out of the will of God. We are the body of Christ. We are children of God. We do live for the Lord, and we have to protect our community. We have to protect our church family. We have to protect our friends. We have to do whatever it takes to help our community, to lead our community, to guide our community. And I know sometimes it's hard because we want to be part of the crowd. We want to be part of the in crowd. We want to be cool. But guess what? Our families are failing. Our friends are failing. Our children are failing. Our community is failing because we're letting drugs overtake our streets. We're letting drugs overtake our community. We're letting drugs overtake our home. Y'all watch your family. Watch your children. When you see things that aren't right, you have to pay attention so you can be attentive so you can save your family's life. You have family members that begin to act strange and act standoffish. Those are some of the symptoms. Those are some of the signs.
when they begin to live personal lives and don't want you to be a part of their life, when they were friendly, when they were spending time with you, and now they don't want to be around you, you have to watch those things. Who is he talking to? Who is he hanging with?
Man, I ain't going nowhere else today. I'm going home. I'm about to go chill back out. Man, leave me alone, all right? Just leave me alone. Hey, just leave me alone. I'm about to go over here and hand him out. Just... What? Oh, my goodness. Oh, get on my nerves. Man. Will you stop talking to me? Shoot. I don't worry me now. Hey, I'm gonna get a good one. Oh.
God is a good God, ain't it? Come on, give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Tell the Lord, thank you. This is a Sunday morning service. Tell God, thank you. God is a good God. Come on, give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Can't nobody do you like Jesus. Can't nobody do you like the Lord. Come on, clap your hands and give God praise. All the highest praise belong to the Lord.
He's into the church, he sings in the choir, he celebrates with God, but he also likes popping pills, drinking, and hanging out with people in the world. See, what Quincy is doing is, he's playing like he's really a child of God, like he truly lives for God, and he's celebrating with God every Sunday, but he hasn't made the choice to really build a true relationship with God. He has not proven that he loves God and he's securing his spot in heaven with the Lord. So what's going on is we have Pastor Rosenberg and he's over New Life Deliverance Church and he spent time with Quincy and he's trying to build a relationship with Quincy and he's been trying to teach Quincy that you can walk in the will of God and you can overcome the issues, the struggles, and the problems of life. So he come to church Sunday after Sunday trying to celebrate God, trying to live for God, trying to love God. We even have men and women that are proclaiming salvation, but they're walking out of the doors of the church and they're living any and every kind of way that they want to live and they're expecting heaven to be their home. So I need y'all to watch what's taking place. Brother Quincy is at church with his mama every Sunday. He ushers on the door. He sings in the choir. But before church can get over, he wants to go out and party. He wants to drink. He wants to pop pills. He wants to smoke weed. And he wants to live. So he's really not concerned about the God we serve. Does it remind you of anybody that you know?
Preach, Pastor Rosenberg.
Father said, let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I wouldn't have told you. I'm going to prayer place for you. And if I go a prayer place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself. I come to let you know that there's a way out through the Lord. I don't care
what to do. I don't care what the situation look like. There's a way out through the Lord. I remember a long time ago when the children were born in the land of Egypt. God raised up a man by the name of Noah, told him to go down and tell Pharaoh.
Taking place in Brother Cole. Pull up a little bit. They can't hear you. Drive up some more. To church early because he got a friend that he want to go hang out and pop pills with and have drinks, because hanging out and partying was more important than doing the will of God. Do you know anybody that's always rushing out of the service early, that always got something to do, that make God like he is of no effect? And do you know anybody that make God like he ain't nobody or he ain't nothing, because our lives are much more busy than celebrating the author and the finisher of our faith? Come on, boys. It looked like we got an overdose going on in the car. Tell him to roll the window down, John.
Roll your window down. You can't hear you. Talk. Roll your window down. You can't hear you.
We got a fireman in route. We got a fireman right down the street getting ready to come up right now. We got a fireman coming up right now.
Trying to
be resuscitated. He made the decision not to do the will of God.
We're trying to continue to resuscitate. And this time
we have those
folks. We've done all we can do.
So Quincy has died due to partying and doing everything out of the will of God. Sometimes you begin to think that you want to hang out in the world, but the world does not love you. They'll leave you for dead. They'll leave you broken, they'll leave you hurt, they'll leave you shamed, they'll leave you lost in the world. And guess what? You had a home in the house of God. You had a home in the body of Christ. But you have an opportunity to win today. You got to build the relationship with God today. You have a chance to have victory. You have a chance to be with your strong church family. Quincy is now dead. Quincy has now officially lost his life. We have a brother Redmond that went crazy on weed. He's dealing with issues, problems, and situations. Brother Quincy is now on his way to the morgue. He has to have an autopsy. His mother is not even aware. See, Quincy's mother is still at church celebrating and praising God. Not aware that her son has left church to go get high and hang out in the world. So this is why we have to watch our children. This is why we have to watch the people in our community. Because there are a lot of things going on and we're being naive. We're acting like we're so holy. We acting like we're so righteous. But now Quincy's mother has just found out that her son has overdosed and died. So many mothers so many fathers, so many aunts, so many uncles that are torn by the deception that the enemy displays. Is it you? Is it your mother? Is it your family? Is it your children? This is what's going on in our community. Will you be the one to help stop it? Will you be the one to draw nigh to God? Because the Bible says if you draw nigh unto God, he'll draw nigh unto you. See, I need y'all to understand that we still have Brother Redman out here lost, hurt with shame and sorrow. Then not only that, Brother Quincy has just died because he chose to leave the house of God to go hang out in the world with people that don't have no love for him. And now Brother Quincy is dead. His life is over when he had a beautiful life with God.
Help me, God.
Help me, Lord. Help me, God. Amen. Come on, Minister Shanique. Let's get ready for the service. Pastor Rosenberg, can you come comfort and encourage Minister Shanique? Because everybody needs a pastor. There are so many people in our community that don't even have a pastor to encourage them. When their kids are shot and killed, when their children overdose and die on drugs, when their children wind up in prison, when their children are lost and hurt. I'm here to tell y'all, so many people are broken, so many people are torn. Pastor Rosenberg, can you just show us some love? Can you do what pastors do when families are broken, when families are torn? What do you say to them, Pastor Rosenberg?
Baby, you done all you can do. You done the best that you can do. You have to do what's going on there. You put them in the hands of the Lord. And one thing about it, God will never leave you, nor will he forsake you. And remember, when you've done all, you know, you brought them to church on Sunday. You prayed for them. You taught them the way. You yield to temptation. But God will take care of you. Be encouraged. It's going to be all right.
So now, we also have to think about the fact that all of our families are struggling. All of our families are going through some stuff. Like Brother Quincy's mama lost her baby, but Brother Quincy's mama don't even have insurance to bury her baby. And now they put up bottles in stores to try to raise the money to bury her son. Have you made preparation if something was to happen to your children? Do you have life insurance? Do you have the love and compassion for the rest of your kids to get through death? Because Minister Shanique has several children that she still has to provide for, that she still has to encourage. But guess what? She still has to make it through the funeral. Who's to say that her heart might go into cardiac arrest? You don't know what could possibly happen. You don't know what could possibly go on. I need all of my people to get prepared for the funeral. If you were called and you're part of this funeral, if you're part of this family, I need you to come. I see Brother Redman is still going crazy. He's looking stupid and acting foolish all on weed. See, we got ushers on the door that take care of the house of God. When people act up and when people get foolish and they start doing things around our church, we have people that will take care of the church. We have people that look out for the church, that look over for the church, and it's not always the pastor. But we have ushers that will show up and get people in order when they're out of line in the house of God.
Jesus. No. What about a Jesus? I don't see no Jesus.
Archie Quinch. Man.
I lay my hands on him. In the name of Jesus. Brother Jesus.
The Bible says these signs shall follow them that believe. See, what has taken place is Brother Redman lost his mind on marijuana, but the power of God has allowed Apostle Rosenberg to lay hands on him, and those demonic spirits had to leave his body, had to leave his mind, so his life has officially went back to normal. In other words, he's at a place in his life where he wants to give God praise and glory because of the gift of laying hands. So I want y'all to know that God is still real. Brother Redman is celebrating and thanking God because now he can finally see again. Now he know his life has been restored. But we have a drug dealer that has showed up to the funeral. We have Brother Quan showing up to the funeral. Now these are all the people that sold Brother Redman the weed, and they decided to show up for the funeral. We have Brother Quan that was inviting them to go get high and party. See, sometimes you got people waiting on you outside of the church to get you high, to pull you down to the ground, to make your life messed up. In other words, they're being used by the devil to destroy your life.
We here to celebrate the life of Brother Quincy. He worked paper in the church. I tell you, God got a love that won't quit. I don't care what you go through with. He said, I'll be with you even to the end of the world. That's how I know God got a love that won't quit. How you get this love? Romans 10:9 said, if thou shalt confess with the mouth the Lord Jesus Christ and believe in the heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Will it be one?
Is Apostle Rosenberg have been called to preach this funeral, and because God has blessed the church with such a powerful word, you have a man that has been delivered from marijuana, and it was laced with fentanyl, and he went crazy, but God, with the gift of laying hands, has been a blessing to Brother Rick that had the privilege of seeing God heal, deliver, and set free. And now the drug dealer wants to be free from selling drugs.
Remain
life out of the will of God, because he's seen holiness through God and the power of God.
Will it be another?
What must I do to be saved?
Save me. Romans 10:9 said, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus Christ, and shall believe in the heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Will it be another?
I want to be saved.
Romans 10:9 said, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus Christ, and believe in the heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Would it be or not?
I won't be saved.
This is Brother Marshall. Everybody think he an outcast and don't think he loved Jesus Christ because of some of the things that he did. But if it wasn't in his heart, he wouldn't want to confess Jesus Christ as his Lord and Savior. He got to be in your heart. Lift your hands.
Romans 10 and 9 said, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus Christ and believe in the heart that God has raised Jesus from the dead, the same one that you crucified, thou shalt be saved.
Hallelujah.
Now what has just taken place is God has brought total deliverance through the land. If you're not saved on today, today is your opportunity to receive victory. You're never too young to give your life to the Lord. You're never too old to give your life to the Lord. There are so many struggles that each and every one of us are dealing with, but today is your day. You don't want to be heartbroken like Minister Shanique. You don't want to be like Brother Redman that went crazy off of weed laced with fentanyl. You don't want to be like the drug dealer that was hanging out around the church that was being pretty cool. You don't want to be like Brother Quan that showed up to the church and pulled over to the side of the road waiting on his friends. Not only did Brother Quan have drugs on him and ready to get high and ready to ride for the party, but guess what? Brother Quincy was sitting in the service with drugs in his pocket. I came to let y'all know that death waits on no man. Death is looking for each and every one of you every day. But I came to let you know that you have an opportunity. You have the right to the tree of life. All you have to do is believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord. All you have to do is believe that Jesus Christ was raised on the third day. And at that very moment, you will receive victory. You will become a winner. In other words, you will become an overcomer. And another thing, you can save your family. You can save your children. You can save your kids. You can save your community. But you got to do it. You got to make up your mind. The sign says, how will you end up here? And as you see, there's a casket here. It says, will it be drugs? Will it be weed? Will it be crack? Will it be alcohol? Will it be meth? Will it be heroin? Will it be prescriptions? But see, it doesn't stop there. Will it be peer pressure? Will it be guns? Will it be gangs? Will you have a big homie or a little homie? Who are you looking up to? Are you looking up to the pastor in the community? Are you looking up to the big homies at the school? Are you looking up to the big homies in the streets? Who are you reverencing? Who are you relating your life to? Who are you willing to lay your life down and die for? Because guess what? We show up to the church Sunday after Sunday. We playing with this thing. We acting like we're really living. We acting like we really love God. But to be totally honest with you, we're running game on God. If you're going to do it, the Bible says in Colossians 3 and 23, whatever ye do, do it heartily, as unto the Lord and not unto men. Will you be killed for stealing? I met a man once that got caught stealing and got shot trying to climb out of the window of somebody's house. He's now a pastor because God allowed him to live. Guess what? Are we sneaking in stores and taking stuff that we have no business? What are we doing that's going to hinder us from living a righteous life for God? This is your opportunity. Make some decisions, my friends. I would like to thank y'all for coming out to see this skit, to be a part of this skit. I would like to thank New Life Deliverance for collaborating with Church in the Streets to bring this to you all. I want to thank everybody that was a part of the skit, everybody that was a part of serving the food, everybody that was a part of the community. Yeah, we had to do it rushly, and we couldn't do it the way we planned because the rain came in, but I wanted to give y'all a tidbit of what Church in the Streets is really all about. See, we have so many different skits, and the skits that we do are about everyday life. They're about the things we're going through. They're about the things we're dealing with. They're about everyday life. I'm telling you, all of us are going through something, but we have an opportunity for victory through Jesus Christ. Church in the streets, y'all have a blessed day. Y'all continue to party and celebrate. The drinks, the food, everything is free. Through the New Life Deliverance, some of the members, not only that, we have Blessed by the Best Associates, LLC. We have Church in the Streets itself, Preacher Boy Trucking, and a few other donators. I don't know all the names, so I can't call everybody that donated, but we want to thank Pastor Katrina. Can you come here? Evangelist Dana Wilson, can you come here? Miss Church in the Streets, Apostle Rosenberg. We want to thank all of y'all. We want to thank Bishop Redman. We want to thank Brother Quan. We want to thank Brother Ted. We want to thank Brother Quincy. We want to thank Apostle Sparks, you know, for being the fireman. You know, we just want y'all to understand and realize that, hey, we do this because we love y'all. We do this because we're concerned about you guys. And we want y'all to win. We want y'all to have victory. And I'm going to tell y'all something. If you know something that's going on in your community that's going to tear your family down, that's going to tear your children down, you need to do whatever you got to do to help them get straight. If you know it's going to destroy their life, tell somebody. I want to give my wife a chance to speak. This is Mrs. Church in the Streets. She's one of the pioneers to everything I do. And I do not take it lightly. I appreciate you, baby, and I appreciate you supporting everything that God shows me. Is there anything that you would like to say?
No, I would just like to thank everyone that participated on today. And as you see, if you need transportation, I have a Miss Dana's Care bus. It seats 16 people. If your price is right, you can ride.
Hey, look, I want to give Pastor Katrina Clark Rosenberg and Apostle Rosenberg a chance to speak. But I need everybody that was a part of Church in the Streets that has the Church in the Streets shirts. Can y'all come at this time? Because we're going to take a picture. I need you to take a picture in as well. I want you to get them on the video. Everybody that has Church in the Streets shirts, can y'all come? Hey, Brother Quincy. My boy, come on, come on, come on. Y'all come on with them Church in the Streets shirts on.
Come
y'all
on, come Cameron, on. All of y'all. Cameron.
Come on, come on. Everybody that collaborated, because this was definitely some heartfelt stuff. We really had to invest time in this because we wanted everybody to see and get an opportunity to know that you can change your life. It doesn't take long. It's not very hard. Come on, y'all, line up up here. Pastor Katrina and Apostle Rosenberg, I need y'all right here because y'all are the foundation of this church. Y'all come on up like y'all taking a picture.
I'm gonna go ahead and say what I got to say as Pastor Rosenberg. Thank you, Juan. Thank you all for coming out to make this service this afternoon a success for Church in the Street, for the sponsors here on this afternoon, our elder Pastor Wilson and Evangelist Wilson, who brought this all the way from Kinston, North Carolina. Amen. Just for the town of Vanceboro. Amen. Sorry that it rained a little bit, but thank you for y'all for coming out and just sharing your time with us. Again, we great bread. But look what the Lord has done ministry. I would like for them to come join in with this picture too. Come on, look what the Lord has done.
Everybody,
ministry.
Come on.
They have came out and helped support, sponsor, and places. They are working just as hard as New Life Delivers to make sure this day said, come on, Apostle Sparks and Pastor Sparks. Stand right here with me and Pastor Apostle Rosenberg. Come on up here on the front line. I know y'all don't want to be on the front line. Amen. But we thank God for them. They're with us all day long. Supporting what we're trying to do here. Make a change in the community. God bless every one of y'all in the hands of Apostle Rosenberg.
We thank God for everyone that showed up for Church in the Street to help us to close out our revival, Teenagers Revival. We just thank God for Pastor Spots and Overseer Spots for the service that they gave to come out and help us, and the other churches getting around and about
this community to happen. There ought to be more people out here because drugs and gangs is going on right here in the city of Vanceboro. And I want to say one thing. God just didn't put this church here in the middle of Vanceboro for it to be lost. God put that church in the middle of Vanceboro for a reason and for a purpose. And I thank God for all of my friends back there in the back, the houses back there in the back. Come on, give Vanceboro a hand clap of praise. Come on, get a mail a hand clap of praise to let me have church in the street. Brother Kite, he let me have church in the street. He could have said no.
That's right.
But he said yeah.
Right.
The boys just stay right there. They could have said no. But everybody know me in Vanceboro and they said yeah. So I thank God for them. I'm going to have Overseer Smarts to have some words.
I just want to thank God for just being a part of this. I enjoy this skit so much. As Apostle Rosenberg said, there should have been more people out because drugs is in everybody's town. I don't care how big or how small. There's a drug dealer, a drug user on every corner. I just thank God for y'all having us to be a part of this.
I would like to say I'm on the front line of it. I see it every day, day to day. I see many, many young people. I can go back and tell you last week we probably had 5 or 6 overdoses. See them when I get to them, they got needles stuck in both arms. We try to bring them back and the first thing the family tells you is we hit them with Narcan. Narcan is a drug that'll help try to bring them off that high and bring them back. But peer pressure's out here. And I try to encourage every young person that I can. You don't have to go down that road. And I encourage the adults to try to help these young people. When they need somebody to talk to, we need them to talk to us. We need to be the light for them so they can come to us and we can help them get through whatever they're going through.
Again, thank you everyone, especially to the musicians that came out. I'm going to do this scheduled time to help us out on this afternoon. We love every one of you back in the hands. I want to thank God because I went out there and lift my hands to God and I told God to stop the running.
Yes, sir.
You got to live holy.
That's right.
And you got to live right. Back in the hands of. Again, for some of you that didn't know, Pastor Elder Tyshawn Wilson ran a 2-night revival here Thursday and Friday along with his wife, helping out and supporting. Come on, give them a big round of applause for being a part of New Life Deliverance and coming and doing thus says the Lord. We love you. We love you. I love y'all. Y'all come into church. You do what you can do. And you know, they really work from their heart. They give all. He be preaching, sweating everywhere. I be like, whew. The time I ain't got soaking wet, I'm about ready to sit down. But he don't care how well he get, he keep right on pushing. So come on, let's give it up for him again. For letting God use him, even on this afternoon. This is all because he allowed God to use him back in his hands.
Amen. We already got the picture, church in the streets. Let's celebrate. Let's eat some of this food up. Let's just have communion. Let's love on each other. Let's party, y'all. Ain't no party like a Holy Ghost party. We celebrating Jesus on the day. God bless y'all. And let heaven continue to smile upon you. Church in the streets.
Thank you.
Welcome,